Good morning. We'd like to welcome everyone to church today here in the building and also in Zoom. Let us join together in the call of worship, please. We are all one family made in the image of God.
We are all one family.
We are all one family, each unique, each special.
We are all one family, brothers and sisters on the journey of faith.
We are all one family, given gifts and talents to share.
We are all one family, united in love, united in peace, united in Christ our Lord.
Let us bow our heads in prayer, please. Father God, I come before you and I lift up this church family to you. I can't thank you enough, Lord, for the blessings that you have given us through the talents of all these people. Father God, I ask for your blessings on today's service. Speak through Pastor Sally. Give her the words to say and us ears to hear. Be with those that are on Zoom. I pray for them that they will be healthy and that they will be safe in your care as well. Be with us as we surrender all to you today. And Father, we thank you for the prayer that you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now we will have our opening hymn, Open the Eyes of My Heart, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. now we will have announcements read by Carolyn.
Good morning. Welcome to our church service, both in person and those on Zoom. Here are your announcements. As in weeks past, to help us have a convenient service for your protection, we have a list of rules and guidelines posted. Register attendance with the ushers. The fellowship hall and basement are closed. Ushers will seat and dismiss you. The bathroom behind the elevator is open and necessary. If children need to use the restroom, please have them accompanied by a parent or an adult. And if you have a compromised immune system, please stay home and watch us through Zoom. Masks are recommended if you're here in person. The flowers on the altar are given by Gordon and Rosalie Hoff in honor of fall birthdays. Lovely. The jar for the Nigerian Orphanage Nickel Project is sitting in the entrance table when you came in if you wish to give to this amazing ministry. Share Bears are collecting grocery cart receipts from now until March of 21. If you have any grocery cart receipts, bring them to the church office during the week or put them in the box at the entrance every Sunday. We sent out activity packets for Sunday school last week. One of the activities is to memorize their first Bible verse. And we encourage them to have mom or dad record them after memorizing it and download it on our Facebook page so the church family can see how well they are doing. If you want to participate, please call the church and we will email the criteria to you. So we need one or two volunteers or more to help clean up the flower gardens by the parking lot for the fall. It would be greatly appreciated. And lastly, there are pears. The pear tree out front was bountiful this year. There's sacks of pears and they'll be outside when you leave. If you're interested in getting some, there's about 12 pears in each bag. Some of them are green, but they will ripen nicely. Next we have Oakland Red Nest with Swing Low.
Swing low, swing chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, swing chariot, coming for to carry me home. This train is bound for glory, this train. Jesus, Jesus, this train is bound for glory, this train. Jesus, Jesus, this train is bound for glory, all aboard for the gospel store. This train is bound for glory, this train. Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. When those gates be open wide, I'm gonna sit by Jesus' side. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord. Swing low, swing chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, swing chariot, coming for to carry me home. This train is bound for glory, this train. Jesus, Jesus, this train is bound for glory, this train. Jesus, Jesus, this train is bound for glory, all aboard for the gospel store. This train is bound for glory, this train. Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord. When those gates be open wide, I'm gonna sit by Jesus' side. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord.
Excellent job, Oakland. Wow, you brought smiles all over this place. And I'm sure on Zoom, but you know what? You made Jesus really happy. What a praise. Thank you. Well, today we have pastoral and offertory prayer, but the focus for the Great West District is Kimball United Methodist Church. So be remembering them this week as well. We have prayer requests for Sue Henning's brother, Randy Vaughn. He lives in Illinois, and he's hospitalized because they believe he has had a stroke. Her poor family has just really had a hard time this year. And we want to lift Kim Payne up in prayer. I have a note to pray for her on the 24th. And we need to pray for Rhonda Berger. She will have knee replacement surgery on the 30th. And I received a message today, prayers for a friend who has depression and has a drinking problem and is suffering and is needing great help. So please be remembering that person. So let's go to God in prayer. Father God, we come before you, and I thank you for these many prayer requests that have been brought forward. I ask for your blessings upon each person, and that you will help them through whatever difficult situation they're in. And you know, God, we know there are many prayers that have not been brought forward. So we ask for you to help those people that are in our hearts that were not spoken. And we give you praise, honor, and glory because we know you love them. And I know, Father God, you will answer prayers. And Lord, we do lift up the Kimball United Methodist Church. We give you praise that they're there, and we pray for their services today. Lord, I can't thank you enough for the love that you show to us every Sunday. And we can't thank you enough for the offerings and the tithes and gifts that are given. I pray, Father God, that you will use those for your best interest to bring you joy and honor in this world. So be with us as we carry on and enjoy this service today. What a glorious day we have, Lord. Thank you. In the name of Christ, I pray. Amen. And now we're going to sing, Lord, You Have Come to the Lakeshore. Oh,
Now we will have our scripture readings by Linda Tucker.
Good morning. Our scripture reading is from Psalms 139, verse 1 through 10. You have searched me, Lord, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you, Lord, know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, and you lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to obtain. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. Now we have children's time. And I don't know who's doing it this morning, since Kim is not here. Do you kids want to come down and sit in front?
Yeah, come on down.
Well, good morning, everyone. How are you? Good. Awesome. I love hearing that. Well, Pastor Sally is going to talk about He knows my name. Who do you think he is?
Jesus.
You guys are good. God and Jesus, you're right. God does know our name. Do you know that he created you in his image?
Yeah,
how cool. Your dad tells you that every day? Good.
That does me too.
Oh, cool. And we talk about it at chapel at Share Bears, don't we? Yeah, we do. And you, Oakland girl, sang out with that beautiful voice. And he knows you. He gave you that voice. What an honor. He knows all of our names. And what a glorious time that we belong to somebody so special that is even bigger than us. You know, sometimes when people, you go somewhere and they don't know your name, does it kind of feel funny when they say, "Hey, you, what are you doing?" It's like, you don't know my name? Maybe some people don't, but you know what? There is always somebody with us that does, and that's God, our Creator.
And Jesus,
you're right. And the Holy Spirit lives within us, right? That's a boy. So, folks, I want you to remember, when you get to feeling lonely, God knows your name, and he calls you and is holding you. We give God praise, don't we? Okay, let's say a little prayer. Father God, we come before you and thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord, for knowing our name. You know, God, we go through every day, and we do take things for granted, and we're sorry for that. But Lord, we know that you're always with us, even in our darkest times and in our brightest times. So be with us and allow us to feel proud of who we are, because we belong to you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to be back in God's house. When Pastor Gideon asked me, he said, "How are you feeling?" I have been struggling with sinus infection. So every day he's calling me, "Are you sure you feel like doing this? Do you feel like doing two Sundays?" I said, "Yes, Pastor Gideon, just go enjoy your vacation. We'll handle it." So this morning I wanted to talk to you about knowing someone's name. My son called me one Sunday after church, and he said, "Mom, have you heard this song? It's called He Knows My Name." So I went home and got on the computer and found the lyrics. And this is the piece of it that I really liked. He knows my name. He knows my every thought. He sees each tear that falls, and he hears me when I call. That should be a good reminder for each of us this morning that no matter where we are or what we're going through, we have a God that knows. We have a God that cares. And we have a God that sees. As I was preparing this message, I got out my Bible and I looked for times that God called the names of people. And I found them throughout the Old Testament and the New Testament. He knew each individual, just as he knows each one of you. And it's a really good feeling if someone calls you by name. If I say, Joe, it's nice to see you this morning. Or Mary, can you help me with this? It's kind of hard to describe the feeling that you get that someone really cares and knows your name. But I can remember a time when I didn't want to hear my name. And that was when my mom used my whole name. Even though our Father knows our whole name, I'm convinced that most of the time he just calls us by our first name. And he calls us in a soft and loving way. I'm convinced that as busy as we are, if we would just slow down and be still for a minute, we could hear him call. And we would know that he is God. And we would remember what it really feels like for God to know your name. A fellow minister told me a story about his youngest son named Stephen. He told me about a conversation he had had with his wife. And his wife was addressing envelopes to send out some invitations. And Stephen was watching her. So she wanted to know if he really understood what she was doing. She said he was about 3 or 4 years old. But she wanted to see how much Stephen knew. So she said, Stephen, where do you live? Right here in my new house. She said, yes, you're correct. And she asked him if he knew what street he lived on. Ridgeway. And he was so pleased with himself that he knew what street he lived on. And then she said, what is your last name? And there was a pause. And then he blurted out, Joshua Stephen. Well, that's your first and middle name. But what is your last name? And after a long pause, he finally said, come here, Joshua Stephen, come here. If he didn't know his last name, he at least knew where he was supposed to be. And sometimes I wonder if it wouldn't do us more good if we knew where we were instead of exactly who we are. But I wanted to remind you this morning that we serve a God that not only knows where we are, where we're going, and who we are. The scripture that Linda read this morning tells us that he knows everything about us. So I thought, I'll check and see some of the people that he called by name. You can't begin to count them all, the stories in the Bible. But the first person that he called by name was Adam. You know the story about Adam. After God had created a beautiful place for them to live and provided for them everything they would ever need, he placed one restriction on them. and that was to leave just one tree alone that was in the center of the garden. But like us, the very thing we're not supposed to have is the thing that we want. And you know the story of the sin and the fall, and that brings us to Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through 10, after they had sinned. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and they hid from the Lord among the trees in the garden. But the Lord called to them, "Adam, where are you?" And he answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and we hid." Aren't you glad that we serve a God that when we sin and when we hide, he comes looking for us, not to punish us, but to call us back to him? When Adam was in sin and when he was ashamed, God knew his name. When he was embarrassed and when he was disobedient, God still knew his name. I like a phrase that I heard from a man named Paul Burleson that says, "There is nothing you can do to make God love you anymore, and there's nothing you can do to make him love you any less." He still knows your name. So this morning when you are discouraged, guess what? He knows your name. When you are hurting, when you want to give up, he knows your name. He knows our every thought, and he sees each tear that falls. And he hears us when we call. The next person that I thought about was Abraham. And these are all stories that you're familiar with, but sometimes I think we miss part of it if we're not careful. This is a great story of God knowing someone by name. God called Abraham by name many times. Abraham is a great example for us to follow, because every time God called his name, he not only heard, but he obeyed. So God called his name and he said, "Abraham, I want you to pack up your family and your belongings, and I'll show you where to go." Now, we have a hard time parking, packing, and leaving when we know all the details of where we're going. But Abraham obeyed even if he didn't know all the details. This morning, God may be speaking to some of us about something, and we're hesitating because we don't have all the details. But we need to be obedient when we hear God call our name. One lesson we can learn from Abraham is that would do us good this morning is the fact that God called his name and he was always listening. I am convinced that we often miss when God calls our name because we're too involved in our lives and the world instead of our relationship with God. "Abraham, take your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains I will tell you about." Early the next morning, Abraham got up and saddled his donkey. Abraham immediately obeyed. He obeyed even when it didn't make sense. But when you hear him call your name, you know that he will be with you and he will lead you. It makes it a whole lot easier to do the stuff that doesn't make sense if we remember that God will lead us. And the last part of Abraham's story is the most important part, because if Abraham hadn't been listening, he might well have missed the most important call of his life. During a time that Abraham may have been confused, during a time when he didn't know what was happening to him, during a time that he might have been unsure of life itself, his missing God call him by name could have been devastating. Abraham took his son Isaac and placed him on the altar and was about to kill him. And in verse 11, it says, the angel of the Lord called out to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham, here I am, Lord, he replied. Do not lay a hand on the boy, God said. Do not do anything to him. Now that I know you fear God, because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son. How many times do we suffer because we don't hear when he calls our name? I can't help but think that as God's chosen, it's so important that we're always listening for him to call. There are so many others that God called by name. Moses, Joshua, Noah, Jonah, Elijah, David, Samuel, and that's just a few. But I want to share again this piece of the scripture that Linda read this morning. Oh Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You know my thoughts from afar. You know my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all of my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. He knows your name. He knows your every thought. He sees each tear that falls, and he hears when we call. So my question in closing, are you listening? Are you listening for God to call your name? Amen.
Our closing hymn this morning is Sweet, Sweet Spirit.
There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place, and I know that it's the spirit of our Lord. There are sweet expressions on each face.
I pray as you leave this place that you will remember to listen for God calling your name. Go in his peace and his love. Amen.
Stop.